mainly focused for students and those are interested in clinical neuroanatomy. So we have got many patients like your CNS stroke or your CNS tuberculosis. Over a span of last 1 month, I have seen 2-3 cases of neurotuberculosis with multiple sequelae. So if you have got a sound knowledge of anatomy, then you can localize and you will get the real charm of diagnosis. Yes, this is the thing. So with this background, I will first touch upon the cerebral cortex and blood supply, especially MCA. Especially MCA and a few interesting slides. So total, I'll take 20 minutes. Please bear with me. So this is your cerebral cortex from lateral side. And this stick, this is a toothpick or mastic, whatever. So it is pointing, it is kept parallel to central sulcus. So this is central sulcus. It comes from the top, down, up to this, up to the lateral sulcus, but it has no anatomical connection between central sulcus and lateral sulcus. And this is the lateral sulcus. So if I put my right hand deep into the deep into the lateral sulcus, then I will touch the insular cortex. Insular cortex is considered as fifth lobe of the brain. So what are the lobes seen in the lateral view? This is the frontal lobe roughly. This is the parietal lobe. This is occipital lobe, temporal lobe. So there are four lobes and this is called fifth lobe. Fifth lobe is the insular cortex. So when I will take you to the medial aspect of the anatomy, you will understand the insular cortex. So this is all about the lateral surface of the brain. Then I'll take you to the prominent midline sulcus. It's called central sulcus of Ronaldo. So anything in front is your frontal lobe. Anything behind is parietal lobe. So this is a strong anatomical landmark. See, it has come down up to this. It has no anatomical continuity with the lateral sulcus. So if I put my finger down till this end, I will feel a omega-shaped structure here. Omega-shaped structure. So in the front, it is the motor cortex. In the back, it is the sensory cortex. So here, it is the central sulcus. In front, it is the motor cortex. And back is the sensory cortex. So there are many sulcuses, but take one or two message from each slide. Don't jam up your brain with multiple information. So if you are interested, I can take one class of one lobe only. So this is your top view of a special MRI scan where this red is central sulcus. It's coming up to this. So, and is a omega-shaped body. So this is the central sulcus and this is your lateral sulcus. If I take my hand or finger deep into this lateral sulcus, I will hit in a cortex called insular cortex. Insular cortex is considered as the fifth lobe of the brain because insular cortex, your controls, modifies, coordinates all functions of the brain. So as soon as I will go deep into the slides, then you will understand the importance of insular cortex. So just remember, this is the central sulcus. In front is the frontal lobe and this is the motor cortex. It controls our all motor activity, supplemented by huge area in the frontal lobe called supplementary motor cortex. The histological difference is a peculiar MCQ that supplementary motor cortex, this area with a large pyramidal cell and motor cortex, little bit smaller pyramidal cell. And this area is the frontal eye field. Next is your, from the lateral side, this is your sensory cortex and rest is your, yellow is your parietal lobe. Here is the temporal lobe and temporal lobe, this part is mainly your receptive hearing. We develop receptive hearing at 1.5 years of age. We mature and develop. And at 2 years of age, we develop expressive speech. So this center or broadcast mature at full extent at 2 years of age, along with this connection. So just take, this is the lobal anatomy in brief, and I have focused the two area, the hearing area, or is a motor area, is the speech area. So broadcast area is called area 44, 45 is broadcast, and here area 21, 22 is your pharynx or sensory. So these 44 and 45 is responsible for production of voice and articulation speech. This we develop at 2 years of age. Baby develops expressive language to the tune of 20 words or to the tune of 10 to 20 words at 2 years of age. Expressive language. Next is homonucleus is very important. This is the motor and this is the sensory. So there are two on each side, sensory motor and sensory motor. So motor is in the frontal lobe and sensory in the parietal lobe. So just remember this face, and above the face is the palm. Above the face is the palm. So here face, then your jaw, tongue, pharynx. So face and thumb are very close. Face and thumb. This knowledge we need in case of explanation of facio-brachial monoplegia. Facio-brachial monoplegia, this knowledge we need it. I will explain it in subsequent slide when I describe the anatomy of MCA. So my dear friend, this is the lateral sulcus. Sorry, where is the pointer? Yes. This is the lateral sulcus ending. So this area is insula. This area is insula. Somewhere this area is insula. So next is again a little bit more descriptive anatomy. So supplementary motor area is very important. This motor area has got wide connection with the deep brainstem, nucleus, basal ganglia and cerebellum, and it has got a direct relationship with the thalamus, thalamocortical connection. So ultimately our head should be always erect in the trunk and neck. So this posture is maintained by supplementary motor area. So if any experimental animal, if I damage the supplementary motor area, he cannot erect his head. He cannot erect his head on the trunk. So this is the little bit developmental aspect. But remember that only 2-3 things. Again, I emphasize Broca's area is 44-45. And your area 4 is the motor cortex, 6 and 8 is the premotor area. This premotor area or supplementary motor area is responsible for accurate and smooth execution of the movement. And this small area is called frontal eye field. This frontal eye field, area number 8, controls the conjugate eye movement and especially saccade. So all of a sudden, if I turn my eye 90 degrees, so this movement is quick and fast. So this is called saccadic movement, saccade. So this is all about this slide. Next, I'll go to a little bit more, but don't remember everything. Just remember area 1, 2, 3. So motor cortex, parietal lobe, sorry, sensory cortex area 1, 2, 3. So area 1 is responsible for joint sensation, skin and joint sensation. Area 2 is responsible for sensation of muscle and joints. And area 3 is responsible for touch, pressure, position, vibration. And there is another area, sensory association area, which is the regulatory area, area 5 and 6. So they are used as superlative area. They categorize warm, warmer, cold, cooler. So this is sensory function of sensory association area, 5-7. So just remember, area 1 is mainly skin and joint sense. Area 2 is deep sense from muscle and joints. And area 3 is touch, pressure, position, vibration. So this is the message bus. Next is your temporal. Temporal again is the main primary auditory area and auditory association area. So there is a peculiar thing. Our hearing is bilaterally represented. Right sided all hearing apparatus has a white connection to left side. Left sided has a white connection to left side. So if anyone is damaged or cut, you will not lose the hearing. Body will take up. It's because there is a white connection. But if both temporal lobe is cut, then it is a real problem. But there is no pathology which can take you out the both the temporal lobe together. It is only possible in experimental animal. So next is your occipital area. This is area 17, area 18, area 19. Area 17 is very specialized area, very specialized area. All specialized functions of visual perception are from area 17. So any small amount of damage in the area 17 will cause lots of problem in the visual perception as well as interpretation. So next is blood supply of brain. Blood supply of brain is, just remember two things, that the center is your direct extension of the carotid. This is the medial cerebellar artery, direct extension. And here via, it is from the subclavian. Subclavian is the vertebral. Just remember the two things. Next is a very beautiful picture. Got it from recent edition of Osborne. Recent edition of Osborne, Clinical Neuroradiology. So this is your MCA. This is MCA. I'll discuss just MCA today. So this is M1 division. We call it horizontal division. Then in the your Sylvian fissure, there are two branches, M2, MCA. I'll discuss in detail just from the undersurface. Don't see anything else. Just see, concentrate on the MCA. I'll discuss only MCA. So there is a communicating artery called, this communicating artery called posterior communicating artery. This artery is a connection between vertebral and your carotid. So carotid is a direct extension and vertebral is via. So this is the connecting artery called posterior communicating artery. Gala kush kush. So now MCA. MCA supplies all lateral surface except the tip. So your tip represented by leg area is not MCA, but represented by face area, palm area, hand is your motor sensory component. This is your MCA. So this is MCA. This is from the top. This is MCA. This is MCA. This is MCA. Just a minute, I have to close the door. Lots of noise. So majority of lateral surface, frontal, parietal, and temporal is supplied by, as in the picture, is supplied by your MCA. Just remember this. Now you have to remember this for your whole life. For your whole life, if you want to localize any MCA territory stroke. So MCA territory can cause complete hemiplegia, can cause monoplegia. And MCA territory only cause temporal lobe, nothing. No monoplegia, no hemiplegia, only this. So anything can happen. So let us start. This is M1 division, which is absolutely horizontal. This is M1 division. Then it goes into the Sylvian fissure. Sylvian fissure, it takes upturn. This is M2 and downturn. This is M3. So this M1 division has lots of small end arteries. We call it lenticulostriate arteries. So these lenticulostriate arteries or end artery stroke leads to a complete hemiplegia secondary to lesion of the internal capsule. secondary to lesion of the, because majority of internal capsule is supplied by MCA. A few smaller area is supplied by ACA. Now, with this image in the background, I will go to little more elaboration. So this is your horizontal part, and again it divides into two, and these horizontal parts. So this is the number three is the lateral lenticulostride arteries. Number four is the Sylvian fissure. We call it Sylvian artery. And so in a nutshell, this is the territory. This is the territory of MCA. Now, if it is lenticulostride, then you will get a contralateral complete dense hemiplegia. But if the superior division is gone, then you will find hemiparesis of face and upper limb, because this area, on the lateral surface of the parietal and frontal lobe, there will be affection of the face. I have shown you the homonucleus. This homonucleus is very clear. So face and thumb, both sensory motor, face and thumb. So fascio-brachial monoplegia, as well as Broca's aphasia, and frontal conjugate gauge paresis, frontal eye field conjugate gauge. So this part, I think I am clear. So this part is supplied by M2 division of MCA. So this part, if it is due to any vasculitis or stroke, then you can get a fascio-brachial monoplegia with your Broca's aphasia. I think I am clear. Next is this inferior part. So inferior part will supply Wernicke's area and especially the optic radiation. Opposite hemianopia, as well as Wernicke's aphasia, as well as another important thing, left hemi neglect. I will come to this. Very interesting hemi neglect. So this is for MCA inferior. So just from this anatomy, if you know this anatomy, and if you find that Wernicke's aphasia is there, you will definitely send the patient to eye referral. By dekho iska hemianopia hai ki nahi. So hemianopia should be there, because molar fiber, we call it Muller's fascicle. I'll show you in the next slide. Muller's fascicle is supplied by same branch. So optic radiation passing through temporal as a Muller's fiber or Muller's fascicle is also supplied by same. So inferior always accompany Wernicke's with hemianopia, and fascio-brachial monoplegia superior division always accompany Broca's aphasia. So this is very fantastic and very nicely explained in Bregis, localization of neuroanatomy. Beautiful book. So next is your ACA. So I think MCA is enough. Next class I will take ACA, or just a snapshot. This top is supplied by your ACA. Here from the top, this is ACA, and this is ACA intracerebral, and this is ACA small chunk in the inferior orbital, medial orbital side is ACA. So ACA is paralysis of leg and feet. So just see, this is the homonucleus, leg and feet, sensory loss, great apraxia, lack of spontaneous motor activity, and urinary incontinence. So all are by ACA. So ACA, A means leg, A-N-L, just remember A leg. ACA, think of leg. Next is your again ACA, okay, forget it. This information is enough. So post-PCA, let us omit for today. PCA, I'll discuss again. So this is, I am omitting. Next is clinical applications. So This is actually 120 slides. I have reduced to 32. So again, I am deleting 3-4 because there is a separate story of ACA, separate story of PCA stroke. So coming to our day-to-day, day-in, day-out practice, so this is the watershed area. This is MCA territory, this is ACA territory. So a pediatrician must have the knowledge of this watershed area because in birth asphyxia, in HIE, these watershed area will go. These watershed area will bear the burn. First, these watershed area will bear the burn. So this is one watershed area, and in the base of the brain, this is one watershed area, and this is one watershed area. But most commonly, we get lots of changes. Now there is a very beautiful ultrasound and echo machine in NICU. So in all premature babies, you will find there is some flare in the posterior part. So that is a different story. So if there is leukomalacia, you will find these kind of changes due to watershed infarct. This is the interventricular hemorrhage. So we pediatrician are mostly concerned with watershed infarct. That is why I have shown you this image. That is why I have shown you this ultrasound image. So please learn this technique of focusing your mid-sagittal as well as frontal, as well as ventricular cut.
Excellent.
As well as ventricular cut in your, from the seniors in NICU. Or if I can step in any day, I can show you the different ultrasound cut and sections. Next is, this is very important, bilateral opercular syndrome or bilateral perisylvian syndrome. This is absolutely depends on your knowledge of clinical neuroanatomy of this area. So this area is nothing but lateral sulcus, sylvian fissure ending into insular cortex. So this area, if bilateral MCA territory infarct is only possible in medical science in HIE, where the blood flow as well as oxygen is compromised. So it is absolutely domain of pediatrician, not the neurologist. So bilateral opercular syndrome is a close differential diagnosis of your cerebral palsy, because there will be paralysis of facial, lots of difficulty in swallowing, paralysis of face, tongue, pharynx, masticatory, and motor aphasia. So this is bilateral perisylvian syndrome, only nicely described in Pijus Gupta's book. It is not in the Nelson. And there is a question 2-3 years back in DNBOSCI. Bilateral perisylvian, the following are common, except. So insular cortex control, I have told you, insular cortex is the fifth lobe of the brain. So it controls personality, anxiety, guilt, punishment, frustration, risky decision making, rejection, smell, hearing. So everything, all lower function is represented to very small extent in insula. So insula is a fine tuning of our brain. That is why it is the fifth lobe. Next, I've told you this interesting story. So when you will come across any pharynx aphasia, or when you come across any homonymous hemianopia or hemianopia, or it is called upper quadrantopia, the molar fibers are lost, then think of inferior division of MCA. So just take this message from today's class. So superior quadrantopia, hemianopia is superior quadrantopia. So always associated the warnings, because the area is supplied by same branch of MCA, inferior branch of MCA. Now the favorite topic of Sir Dr. Kundu, that hemi neglect. So this happens in parietal lobe lesion of non-dominant cortex. So I repeat, parietal lobe lesion of non-dominant cortex. So parietal lobe lesion of non-dominant cortex, it is supplied by your MCA. That is why I put this, parietal lobe is MCA. So we are right-handed person, so our right cortex is non-dominant. Our left cortex is dominant. So just concentrate on the normal. There are three pictures: normal right hemisphere glaciation, left hemisphere glaciation. In a normal person, your right hemisphere controls the both side, right side, left side. So far as neglect is concerned, left hemisphere gives only the right side. Left hemisphere controls only the right side. Sorry, left hemisphere controls only the right side, and right hemisphere controls the both side. So if right hemisphere is gone, so non-dominant hemisphere, there should be non-dominant hemisphere stroke, MCA territory, non-dominant hemisphere stroke. Here you will find that the left side is preserved. So whatever there in the vision, there will be neglect, severe left neglect. If left sided MCA lesion, inferior division mainly, then there will nothing will happen, because this controls both sides. So he has come, this gentleman has come to the office. Without putting the left sleeve. Without putting the left sleeve, he has come to the office. So this is the picture that he is shaving. He is shaving one side. A girl is given a fish curry and rice, and he is neglecting one half of the plate. If you are allowed to draw a watch mounted on the wall, you will draw only the right side. He is neglecting the left side. So this is classical of inferior MCA infarct. So same thing. If you are allowed to draw a picture like this, you will draw only half of the picture. So this is called hemineglect. This is happens in non-dominant lobe lesion, non-dominant parietal lobe lesion. Just remember, non-dominant parietal lobe lesion.
It is sensory neglect or visual neglect?
It is both hobby.
Both.
Because
you should tell them, how do we test hemineglect?
I see. So this is the neglect. So best is a wall mounted clock is there. Please draw the clock. So he will draw the half of the clock. So this is your visual, and kichu ekta object jemon shar jama ta pore this sensory hobe. Next is your agnosia. So another three floor slide left. I've taken only interesting part. So if you are interested, then I can take another class in PCA and occipital lobe. So this is V1 of area 17. So this is responsible for all your visual input. Whatever we are looking at is giving an image at the point V1. From V1, there is a two connection. One is called what pathway? It is connected to the inferior part of the temporal lobe. Where pathway? What I am seeing and where I am seeing. So if there is a posterior PCA stroke or any damage of this part of the brain, so he cannot recognize the face. This is called prosopagnosia. prosopagnosia occurs mainly in this fascicle is damaged, or this part is severely damaged. So there should be this part plus the extension. So this prosopagnosia and if a part, then another many division of prosopagnosia. So this book is extensive, but I have taken very smaller thing just to give you a bird eye view. Next is your where pathway. So here, if this pathway is damaged, he cannot localize where he is. So just remember this. Next, this is called cymatognosia. This has come to this neat pigeon. So simultaneously, he cannot see pyramid, the sky, the moon, the camel. So one object, the safari is neglected. Simultaneously, he cannot concentrate. He can concentrate 2-3 objects and neglect others. So it can be single object, it can be multiple object. So according to, there are lots of finer division. So it is called simultognosia. Simultaneously, many object is neglected. Similarly, visual agnosia, what Sarah was telling, visual agnosia, your visual neglect and visual agnosia. So visual agnosia is another special function of occipital lobe. He cannot recognize anything, but from the outline, he can draw, but he cannot recognize from the what is registered in the memory, he cannot recognize. So he can draw just an outline. This is an apple-like structure, this is a book-like structure. So this is called bit difficult, but if you can understand, yes, you can. Otherwise, just remember visual agnosia is a function of occipital lobe. If there is a damage in the area 17 and this connection, he cannot draw a particular object which is shown in the picture. So this is my last slide. So any question?
Jaydeep, I want to ask you about this hemineglect. Actually, what we do, when you touch, say, on the right side at a particular point, the person can say, yes, you are touching the right side of the tip of the shoulder. You are touching.
Yes, yes, yes.
When you touch the left side, he can say, yes.
Sir, this is called...
But if you touch simultaneously, yes, both the sides, one both side... The side.
This is another function of parietal lobe, where if parietal lobe is lost or damaged or infarct, they cannot localize. This localization is lost. And this is called simultaneous localization. It act too different. But this is a very usable, approachable and referable test.
Suppose you give somebody a key, you don't show...
Agnosia, perceptual agnosia.
Perceptual
agnosia, yes. So just a bird eye view, if you are interested, I can do another 20 minute class on the agnosia.
Agnosia na otho jai ho
mata. Na, dorkar nahi, bas, just, bolun sir.
Jaydeep.
Bolun sir.
First of all, how common these symptoms you find in children? What is the management implications in children?
Herpes simplex virus involves the temporal lobe. It involves all the centers you have just talked. This Wernicke, Broca's, olfactory, gustatory, sob. The middle cerebral artery, lateral side, the butabacally, that particular part is involved by herpes simplex. So it resembles there. Oita important. Kintu stroke as such, the middle cerebral artery, I'm here, I'm not sure.
এছাড়া এখন বাসকুলাইটিস যত বেশি পাচ্ছি আমরা, মানে অ্যাওয়ারনেস বেড়েছে, রাদার আমি বলবো অ্যাওয়ারনেস বেড়েছে, So, এগুলো নলেজ আমাদের দরকার
debatable issue, Joydeep, that what I will be showing, I have a lecture on this Sunday, I think. Yeah, this Sunday on the syndrome. We learn a lot about the pathophysiology of a disease rather than diagnosing the disease. See, the pathophysiology takes away a lot of our time and our brain's space. So what is most important nowadays in the modern world that, first of all, how to diagnose this case and what's the management?
Yeah, apni je bolten je gastrot.
Gastrot
approach.
I mean, MRCP is a 100 pediatric picture test. সেই 100 পেডিয়াট্রিক পিকচার টেস্টে প্রথম পাতায় একটা গ্যাস্ট্রট লাগা আছে পিকনো ডিজস্টোসিসের একটা ছবি আছে নাও বিকজ অফ দ্যাট আই ডায়াগনোজ দ্য পিকনো ডিজস্টোসিস পেশেন্ট দ্য পেশেন্ট ওয়াজ মুভিং ফ্রম ওয়ান প্লেস টু অ্যানাদার উইদাউট এ ডায়াগনোসিস সো দ্যাটস হোয়াট আই ফিল দ্যাট উই নো লট অ্যাবাউট প্যাথোফিজিওলজি rather than the disease diagnosis and the disease treatment. Now, when I went to England, my boss told me that you need to unlearn a lot of things rather than learning.
Aito sir, bideshi boi gula dekhben je just oi dhoroner mane kom kom jinishe beshi bujhiye dicche.
That's what I mean to say je amader to brain er ekta capacity ache. And yeah, also the time constraint to ache. So first of all, how can we diagnose these patients and how can we manage these patients? So ami oderke resident derke bolchilam je ami ekhono MRCP er MCQ kima USMLE er jeta ekhon 1920 cholche they are very simple.
Simple.
Mane
very simple useful. Simple useful mane chinta matha khiye de. মাথা ঘুরিয়ে দেয়
তো তোদের যেমন ডিএনবিটা তো সবই ভালো
ওইটা তো নকল করছে ডিএনবি তো অ্যাবসলিউটলি এমআরসিপি নকল করছে স্যার
হ্যাঁ নকল করছে দে দে শুড বিকজ আমাদের দেশে না আমরা ওই প্যাথোফিজিওলজি পড়ে
কস করতে
when ইউ নিড প্যাথোফিজিওলজি when ইউ আর ডুইং এ রিসার্চ অন দ্যাট ডিজিজ অনলি or you are trying to invent a new treatment for that disease or you are doing a protocol for je ami konta korbo ki na tao protocol e oto ta lage na so that is what I feel je amader mane amar mone ache je dr somitra ray o madhyamike first hoyechilo to o okhane je england e je ওই নার্ভের রুটস গুলো লাইন্স গুলো সব কোনটা দিয়ে কিনটা যাচ্ছে
সব বলে দিচ্ছে
সব বলে দিচ্ছে আর ওরা অবাক হয়ে শুনে তারপরে লাস্টে বলছে যে ডু ইউ রিয়েলি নিড টু নো ইট কারণ আমাদের তো এমআরআই করে লোকালাইজ করতে হবে আমাদেরকে তো এমআরআই করেই লোকালাইজ করতে হবে এই যে আমাদের এত লোকালাইজেশন
ওই যে আমার এমআরসিপি তে যে পলগাঁও যে বইটা পলগাঁও
হ্যাঁ পলগাঁও
এত সুন্দর লিখেছে এত কনসাইজ করে মানে মেসমারাইজড হয়ে যায় মাঝে মাঝে মনে আবার
আমি জানি পলগাঁওয়ের বই তো আমার আছে
আছে
কিন্তু আমরা অনেক বেশি পড়ে ফেলি এন্ড তাতে আমাদের নলেজ গুলো গুলে ঘেটে একটা
অসুবিধা ঘেটে ঠিক ঠিক আমি ছোট ছোট করে আমি 20 মিনিটের মধ্যে শেষ করে দিয়েছি একদম ছোট স্ন্যাপশট যদি ওদের ভালো লাগে
তাহলে আজকালকার যুগে ধর আমাকে এমআরআই
করতে অসুবিধা এটা আগে বেসিক এটা না থাকলে এটা জিনিসটা অ্যাবজর্ব করতে
না এটা তো একদম সহজ করে বললাম স্যার একদম সহজ
সহজ করে বলি সবাইকে
এমসিএ বললাম আমি জাস্ট এমসিএ বললাম আজকে এমসিএটা মনে রাখুক হ্যাঁ এসি আরেকদিন বলবো পিসি আরেকদিন বলবো 20 মিনিট জাস্ট 20 মিনিট
ঠিক আছে গুড
আচ্ছা শুন
হ্যাঁ বলুন স্যার
ওই না না ওই পিজিটি দেরকে বলে দিছিলাম আমি যে কারা কারা ভেজিটেরিয়ান ডায়েট খাবে অন ফ্রাইডে সেটা যেন জানিয়ে দেয় আর কি আর যারা ফ্যাকাল্টি আছে তারা যেন টাকাটা দিয়ে দেয়
টাকা বেশুদারে দেব স্যার আমি জানি তো হসপিটালে যাইনি